Random House Audio Assets presents When Fish Fly, lessons for creating a vital and energized workplace from the world-famous Pike Place Fish Market by John Yokoyama and Joseph Michelli, Ph.D. Read for you by Kevin Gray. Creating a vision of power and possibility, or seeing the big fish, how I took my business from bankruptcy to world fame. For 20 years, I worked hard to make my business, a small fish stand in Seattle's Pike Place Market, successful. During much of that time, I didn't take vacations and was on the job 12 hours a day, 6 days a week. Like many small businesses, my company wasn't a huge success. My hard work and that of my employees resulted in a decent lifestyle for all of us, but I wanted something more for the Pike Place Fish Market. I considered expanding my business. Around 1986, I decided to venture into the wholesale side of the fish industry. It was a huge mistake. I delegated responsibility for our wholesale operation to a person who put me seriously in debt in just 9 months. My business and I were in trouble. Unless I could get $50,000 quickly, the Pike Place Fish Market would face bankruptcy. Because I hadn't borrowed money from banks in the past, I couldn't get a loan when I needed it. Fortunately, my mother-in-law came through with the money. I pulled my team together and told them, it's either sink or swim. We decided to swim, and we stabilized financially. Around the same time, a friend, Karen Berquist, called and suggested that I talk with her husband, Jim, a business consultant, about Pike Place Fish's future. When I met with Jim, he told me he had a unique approach to consulting. Unfortunately, his fee was more than I paid a full-time employee who works 60 hours a week. I told him, you must be crazy. There was no way I was going to pay someone that much to consult with us. Jim told me that if I tried his services for 3 months and he didn't produce what I invested in him, I should fire him. So I took a chance that he could help me create a more profitable future. He and his company have now been working with us for 17 years. Jim brought our staff together in crew meetings every other week to empower us. It was at one of these meetings that he helped us appreciate that we were thinking too small and that we needed a bigger purpose, a bigger game. One crew member's response to that challenge was, let's become world famous. World famous? Us? What does that mean? It seemed like a ridiculous idea. We were a 1,200 square foot fish stand, just recovering from financial disaster. The only way I was going to go for being world famous was if it didn't cost me any money. We had no money to market ourselves. How could we be world famous? But rather than giving up on the idea, we decided to explore it further. We didn't want to just take some standard notion of world fame. We needed to create the concept for us, in our workplace. As we discussed world fame, we realized that by working together, we could affect each other's lives and the lives of our customers in a world-famous way. It was a vision that gave us a powerful purpose for doing business. As Jim puts it, we created world-famous Pike Place Fish, and what it meant to be world-famous was to make a difference for the people we touched. The purpose wasn't just to be famous. It was to be famous for being great with people, for free, just for the fun of it. And that's what happened. With the declaration of world-famous Pike Place Fish, we evolved from a company that existed to sell fish to one that was interested in extraordinary service to our customers and our world. Selling fish was no longer the main reason we were open for business. Don't get me wrong. When you visit the market, we will provide you the highest quality fish and in turn, take your money. Like all small businesses, an important part of our game is to make a profit. But making a profit is not enough. If a manager or owner is interested only in making a profit, then the lens through which he looks at his employees only allows him to see their ability to help him achieve financial success. When the game goes beyond profit to a greater purpose, workers are valued for their ability to create profit and serve others. As a result of our vision, the fish are now only a means to an end. Selling fish gives us an opportunity to make a world-famous difference. And for that, I am grateful. Our vision is large enough and clear enough that it guides our staff in day-to-day operations. It generates a more meaningful reality for all of our employees. They are not simply fish salespeople. They are agents of change. Anyone can sell fish. Few can make a world-famous difference while doing it. Here are my three pledges. As the owner of world-famous Pike Place Fish, I will, 1, make a world-famous difference in the lives of everyone who comes into my business. 2, empower the creative people I work with so that they can make a world-famous difference for each other, the customers, the community, and beyond. And 3, demonstrate what is possible when you empower your employees. These days, I find myself sharing these possibilities with executives in large corporations, as well as with organizations and community leaders. Sometimes my intentions are difficult to live. I must admit that I'm not always being world-famous Pike Place fish. Some days I struggle just to get to work. But even when I am not being purposeful, I know I always have the choice to bring myself back to the vision. With every customer, every crew member, every supplier, and even with you, the listener, I have the choice to live world-famous Pike Place fish. When I miss opportunities to enhance the lives of my customers or crew, I'm very aware of the choices I've made. So, how do you turn around a hostile workplace? Once upon a time, the Pike Place fish market was a pretty hostile work environment. I remember yelling so much I made one fishmonger start to cry. Through his tears, he said, "I can never make you happy." When I wasn't happy, the whole Pike Place market area knew it. Given the way I treated people in those days, Pike Place fish was a revolving door for employees. We had significant problems with employee theft, staff drunkenness, and drug use. If we weren't fighting with one another, we were getting into physical fights with vagrants who tried to steal fish from the stand. In the middle of all this chaos, we were the next to last in profitability of all the fish shops in the Pike Place market. Since we began changing our culture, not only are we consistently at the top of fish sales in the market, it would be difficult to find any retail store in America that makes more money per square foot of retail space. We haven't had a full-time employee leave within the past 5 years. In fact, we have people volunteer to work one day a week with us just to experience our culture. We have a saying at the fish market, "The fish stinks from the head." Unfortunately, I have always been the head of this fish company, so when things smell around here, it starts with me. While it might be easy to blame the problems the fish market used to experience on my staff or other business factors, my attitude shaped our culture. It wasn't until I chose a different way of relating to my employees through our vision that things truly began to change. Once I understood the creative power of people and the importance of offering a place where they could make a difference, Pike Place Fish began to take off. I used to run the fish market as a dictator, and seldom a benevolent one. Even now, we don't run as a democracy. Our crew members share ideas and create suggestions, but because I have the greatest financial stake in the outcome, the final decisions rest with me. We've come to learn that achieving fame and being world-famous Pike Place fish are two very different things. Our intention was not to bring fame to ourselves. Instead, it was to deliver as world-famous fishmongers would. As is always the case, the intentions from which you work bring forth powerful and unpredictable results. Through our vision and our willingness to incorporate that vision into our moment-to-moment encounters, Pike Place Fish has enjoyed more than its share of attention. And what draws many people to us is that our fishmongers throw fish to one another. Shortly after we defined our vision, the Goodwill Games came to Seattle. Photographers and news crews from places as diverse as China, Japan, Zaire, Russia, and Germany trained their cameras on our energized workers. As our fishmongers threw fish and delighted the crowds, the world looked on. Without our spending a dime, stories and pictures of our Pike Place fishmongers were appearing everywhere. Shortly after the Goodwill Games, a movie producer told us that he had seen our fishmongers on television. He proceeded to hire 3 members of our staff to throw fish in the movie Free Willy. After that, ABC's Good Morning America contacted us to be on their show. One of our team members was living world-famous Pike Place fish while watching television. During an MTV program, he heard that Spike Lee was filming a new Levi's commercial, and he wanted to use people with interesting jobs. The fishmonger joined 650,000 other entries, and Spike Lee chose us as a location for one of his jeans commercials. We changed our shipping box and signs around the market by adding the words "World Famous." And the strangest thing began to happen. Not only were we publicly stating our vision, but strangers were communicating it as well. I would stand in the crowd and listen to people as they watched the crew in action. They would say things like, "Oh, I heard about these guys. They're the world-famous Pike Place fish guys." We declared that we were world-famous, and other people actually took the idea and spread it. At one of our meetings, my brother, Dickie, our closet actor, said, "It's time for us to have Pike Place Fish the movie show up." Most of us looked at him and laughed, saying, "Yeah, right." Within a month, John Christensen of Charthouse Learning stopped by the market. He was in town doing a video about a poet, David White, who lived on nearby Whidbey.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.